Good morning, students. In your fifth module, you have to learn about four important reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones. That is, Clemmensen reduction, Wolff-Kishner reduction, reduction using metal hydrides, and the last one is Mewing point of Verle reduction. So, in your last class, we already discussed about Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction. Hope you remember the reagents in Clemmensen reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction. So what is the reagent in Clemmensen reduction? It is zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl. In the case of Wolff-Kishner reduction, it is hydrazine and potassium hydroxide or potassium tertiary butoxide. In today's class, we will discuss about the remaining reduction reactions, that is reduction using metal hydrides and Mewing point of Verle reduction. Now let us discuss about reduction using metal hydrides. For reducing carbonyl compounds in organic chemistry, we use the most important reducing agents as metal hydrides. Two common metal hydrides are sodium borohydride and lithium aluminum hydride. Here is the structure of lithium aluminum hydride and sodium borohydride. In the case of aluminum hydride, this aluminum hydrogen bond is more polar compared to boron hydrogen bond. That means polar means there is great electronegativity difference between aluminum and hydrogen compared to boron and hydrogen. So it can provide hydride ion for reduction very easily compared to sodium borohydride. So lithium aluminum hydride is a stronger reducing agent compared to sodium borohydride. So in this reaction of an aldehyde or a ketone with sodium borohydride or lithium aluminum hydride followed by water or some other proton source yields an alcohol. So what happens in this reaction? First we have to treat the aldehyde or ketone with sodium borohydride or lithium aluminum hydride. Then we have to treat it again with water for providing proton. Then only we will get alcohol. So aldehydes are reduced to primary alcohol. Normally aldehydes are reduced to primary alcohols and ketones are reduced to secondary alcohols. So this reaction involves the addition of nucleophilic addition of hydride ion at the carbonyl carbon. So here is the structure of aldehyde RCHO. So in this reaction, metal hydride reduction reaction, we have to treat the aldehyde with lithium aluminum hydride. This reaction involves two steps, that means the reduction of aldehyde with metal hydrides normally involves two steps. The first one is treating the aldehyde with lithium aluminum hydride. So lithium aluminum hydride provides the hydride ion to add at the carbonyl carbon. This hydride ion acts as the nucleophile, then add at the carbonyl carbon. Then after that we had to treat it with water, then water provides H plus ion. So altogether H2 molecule adds up on the aldehyde, so we will get primary alcohol. In the case of aldehyde, we will get primary alcohol. Here is the structure of primary alcohol, RCH2OH. What is primary alcohol? Primary alcohol means we will have a OH group on the carbon atom, primary carbon atom. So what is a primary carbon atom? A primary carbon atom is a carbon atom which is attached to only one other carbon atom. Here we have only one carbon, that is represented by R. Then primary alcohol Then in the case of ketone, here we can treat aldehyde with lithium aluminum hydride or sodium borohydride. In both case we will get the same alcohol, primary alcohol. But here we have solvent. In the case of lithium aluminum hydride, we have the solvent THF, tetrahydrofuran or ether, THF. In the case of lithium aluminum hydride, there will be a violent reaction when we treat it with alcohol or water. So we had to take alcohol or water or any other. If we take any other protic solvent, that means if we take alcohol or water or any other protic solvent with lithium aluminum hydride, there will be violent reaction. So we had to take aprotic solvents like THF or ether. Protic or aprotic means? Protic means the solvent which can provide H plus ion. Aprotic means which do not provide H plus ion. So THF is an aprotic solvent or ether. So we had to take aprotic solvents for lithium aluminum hydride. In the case of sodium borohydride, we can take methanol or water. Then in the case of ketone, when we reduce it with lithium aluminum hydride and water, we will get secondary alcohol. Here we have the structure of secondary alcohol. So what is a secondary alcohol? Secondary alcohol is having this group CHOH. Primary alcohol is having this group CH2OH part. CH2OH. Whereas secondary alcohol is having CHOH part. That means in this case OH group is attached to a secondary carbon atom. This is secondary carbon. This secondary means a carbon which is attached to two other carbon. In this case, two alkyl groups are here, R and R dash. So an alcoholic group which is attached to a secondary carbon atom is known as secondary alcohol. Secondary carbon means carbon which is attached to two other carbon atoms. So using sodium borohydride and lithium aluminum hydride, we can reduce aldehydes and ketones. So aldehyde will get reduced to primary alcohol, then ketones will get reduced to secondary alcohols. Here we have some examples for reduction using metal hydrides. Here we have ethanol, that is acetaldehyde. On reduction with lithium aluminum hydride followed by treating with water, or we can use sodium borohydride and water, we will get primary alcohol, that is ethanol. Primary alcohol is usually represented with number 1 with a degree symbol, 1 primary. Then another example, butanol. In the case of butanol, on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride and or lithium aluminum hydride or sodium borohydride, we can obtain butanol, that is primary alcohol. So CHO group is reduced to primary alcohol group, CH2OH group. The remaining part will be same. Here we have two ketones. So in the case of butanol, on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride followed by treating with water, or sodium borohydride followed by treating with water, we will get butan-2-ol. So ketonic group on reduction, we will get a secondary alcoholic group, CHOH. Similarly, in the case of acetophenone, CO group on reduction, we will get 1-phenyl ethanol, that is a secondary alcohol. Now let us discuss the reduction of lithium aluminum hydride and sodium borohydride on some carbonyl compounds which contain some additional functional group means here carbon-carbon multiple bond or some other reducible groups. Here we have one example, cyclohapatanone. In this case, we have one ketone functional group and also one carbon-carbon double bond. When we reduce it using heavy aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride, only the carbonyl functional group will get reduced. Here you can see the carbonyl functional group will get reduced to a secondary alcohol. Here cyclohexanol, heptanol, not heptanol, heptanol. The double bond will not get, this double bond will not get reduced. By using both the reducing agents, we will get the same product. That means both sodium borohydride and lithium aluminium hydride can selectively reduce the carbonyl group in the presence of a carbon-carbon multiple bond when compared to catalytic reduction. That means both lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride will selectively, only it will reduce the carbonyl functional group, but it won't reduce, it will not reduce the carbon-carbon multiple bond, double bond or triple bond. But in the case of catalytic reduction, here all the functional groups, carbonyl functional group and double bond, got reduced. Now let us see some more examples for the reduction of aldehydes and ketones using lithium aluminium hydride and sodium borohydride. Actually, lithium aluminium hydride is a powerful reducing agent. As we already discussed that it is a powerful reducing agent because it can provide H minus very easily. It may sometimes reduce other reducible groups like C double bond C and C triple bond C, particularly if they are conjugated with the carbonyl group. That means conjugation means if there is alternate single and double bond, just like this CH2 double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH, like in this case where it, here you can see alternate single and double bonds, double bond single bond, double bond single bond, double bond single bond, double bond. So if there is conjugated bond, if there is a double bond which is in conjugation with a carbonyl functional group, here you can see a carbonyl functional group is in conjugation with a double bond. Double bond conjugation means alternate single bond and double bond. Here you can see one double bond, then single bond, here one more double bond but with oxygen atom. So if there is a conjugation of one single bond, one double bond or a multiple bond with carbonyl functional group, its reduction is very different. Selective reduction of the carbonyl group may not be possible with lithium aluminium hydride. That means if we are using lithium aluminium hydride as a reducing agent, if there is a conjugated bond like this, in the case of carbonyl compounds, so lithium aluminium hydride will not reduce selectively this CHO group. It will also reduce the C double bond C. But in the case of sodium borohydride, it is less reactive compared to lithium aluminium hydride, but it is more selective. It performs selective reduction of carbonyl groups in carbonyl compound, leaving the carbon-carbon multiple bonds intact in the product. That means if a compound contains a multiple bond, carbon-carbon multiple bond, that is C double bond C or C triple bond C, which is in conjugation with a carbonyl group, carbonyl CO group, then if the reagent is lithium aluminium hydride, it can reduce both the part. That means it can reduce CO group and also C double bond C or C triple bond C. But if the reagent is sodium borohydride, it will only selectively reduce the carbonyl function group. It won't reduce, it will not reduce the C double bond C. For example, CH3, CH double bond CH, CHO. Using lithium aluminum hydride, we can see that the product is butene-1-ol. Here all the functional groups, CHO group and CH double bond C, were both got reduced. But in the case of sodium borohydride, it is selective reagent. It only reduces the CHO part, that means carbonyl function group, and the CH double bond CH remains, this part remains intact. This part will remain unaffected. That is, selective reagent is sodium borohydride. Here also you can see one more example. Using lithium aluminum hydride, you can see CO group and CH double bond CH both part will get reduced. CH2, CH2, CHOH. Here you can see a secondary alcohol is produced. But in the case of sodium borohydride, only the carbonyl function group got reduced, not the carbon-carbon double bond. So, from this you can see that sodium borohydride is a selective reagent for the reduction of carbonyl compounds. So, it will not reduce the other reducible function group in the compound. Even if it is in conjugation with the carbonyl group, but in the case of lithium aluminum hydride, it will reduce all the functional group, that means carbonyl group and other reducible carbon-carbon single multiple bond or other reducible groups. This is the last reduction reaction, that is Mervyn Pond of Verler reduction. This reaction is named after three scientists, Mervyn, Pondoff and Verle. So what is MPV reduction or Mervyn Pondoff Verle reduction? MPV reduction is the reduction of aldehydes and ketones to the corresponding alcohols. Aldehydes are reduced to the corresponding primary alcohols, whereas ketones are reduced to the corresponding secondary alcohols when they are heated with aluminium isopropoxide in isopropyl alcohol. Here the reagents are aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. This is the structure of isopropyl alcohol, CH3CHOH. That is propan-2-ol. This is a secondary alcohol. When we replace the hydrogen by a metal, we will get metal alkoxide. Here we are using aluminium. So aluminium has three valency. So we have three such groups. This is bond line formula for isopropyl alcohol. So each line represents CH3. So this is a structure of aluminium isopropoxide. Aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohols are the reagents for this MPV reduction. MPV reduction is reversible, and the reversible reaction is known as open or oxidation. This reaction, here you have two examples for two general reactions for aldehydes and ketones. This is a reduction of aldehyde and ketones using the reagents are aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. So aldehyde will get reduced to primary alcohol, and here we have isopropyl alcohol, it will get oxidized to propanone. Reduction means addition of hydrogen. Here hydrogen atoms will get added up. Here hydrogen atoms, here oxidation occurs, so hydrogen atom will get removed, so we will get propanone. So this is in MPV reduction. Here aldehyde reduction aldehyde will get reduced to primary alcohol. Here we have ketone. Ketone on reaction with aluminum isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. So if we have a ketone, it will get reduced to secondary alcohol. Then same reaction, propanol will oxidize to isopropanol. Isopropyl alcohol undergoes oxidation and we will get propanol. And the reversible reaction means this is forward reaction, this is backward reaction. Forward reaction is MPO reduction and the backward reaction is open or oxidation. Then open or oxidation means oxidation of, usually it is selective oxidation of secondary alcohol. Open or oxidation means it is the oxidation of secondary alcohol. But in some cases, primary alcohol also undergoes oxidation. So, oxidation of secondary alcohol with propanol and aluminum isopropoxide. We will get reversible reaction, that is, secondary alcohol undergoes oxidation to ketone and propanol undergoes reduction to propanol. Propan-2-ol, that means isopropyl alcohol. So reagent for opener oxidation is aluminium isopropoxide and acetone. But in the case of MPV reduction, reagents are aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. Here you can see what is opener oxidation. Oppenheimer oxidation, that is named after Robert Victor Oppenheimer, scientist. It's a gentle method for selectively oxidizing secondary alcohols to ketones. This reaction is specific for the oxidation of secondary alcohols to ketones. But in the case, in some cases, it oxidizes primary alcohols to aldehydes. So this reaction will not affect other oxidizable groups like double bond or triple bond. It will only selectively oxidize a secondary alcohol group to ketones. This reaction also oxidizes primary alcohols to aldehyde. Just the reverse case of Merwin Pond of Weller reduction. This reaction is the opposite of Merwin Pond of Weller reduction. The alcohol is oxidized with aluminium isopropoxide in excess acetone. The reagents are aluminium isopropoxide and acetone. In MPV reduction, the reagents are aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. Here you can see some examples for open oxidation. Here you have one secondary alcohol. The reagents for opener oxidations are aluminium isopropoxide and acetone. So on treating the secondary alcohol with acetone and aluminium isopropoxide, the secondary alcohol will undergo oxidation to ketone. Then this acetone will get reduced to isopropyl alcohol. So here you have one more example. In this case, you have one double bond in addition to this secondary alcohol group. So on oxidation with acetone and aluminum isopropoxide, only this secondary alcohol group will undergo oxidation and you will get a ketone, and the remaining double bond, carbon-carbon double bond, will not get affected. Then acetone will get reduced to isopropyl alcohol. Just the reverse case of MPV reduction. Here, so opener oxidation is very selective. It will only reduce secondary alcohol group to ketone and will not affect the other reducible groups. Here you can see the general reaction, opener oxidation and MPV reduction. In the case of open or oxidation, oxidation of secondary alcohol with acetone and aluminium isopropoxide, you will get corresponding ketone and isopropyl alcohol. But in the case of MPV reduction, you will have the reagents aluminium isopropoxide and isopropyl alcohol. Then you will get the corresponding secondary alcohol and acetone. That's all about our open oxidation and MPV reduction. So far we have discussed some reduction reactions. Based on that we have some conversion reactions. So here we have acetophenone. How can you convert this into ethyl benzene? That means here the CO group is reduced to CH2. This point is represented as CH2 group. So how will you convert CO group to CH2? You can use Clemmensen reduction or Wolff-Kirchner reduction. That means you can use zinc amalgam and HCl or as one reagent, or you can use hydrazine and potassium hydroxide as another reagent. Then another conversion, acetaldehyde to ethanol. Here also this CO group is converted into CH2 group. Same reagents you can use. You can use zinc amalgam and HCl or hydrazine and potassium hydroxide. Here we have crotonaldehyde. This is an unsaturated aldehyde. So how will you convert this into this unsaturated alcohol or in a saturated alcohol? Here you can see this double bond is not affected, but only the carbonyl functional group is reduced. So which reagent we will select here? This is the selective reduction. For selective reduction, which reagent we will use? We will use sodium borohydride. For this reduction, we will use sodium borohydride. So in this case, only the carbonyl function group is reduced. But here, we can use lithium aluminum hydride. It is not very selective. It is highly reactive reducing agent, so it will reduce all the functional groups. Here carbonyl groups and double bond. So here we can use sodium borohydride and here we can use lithium aluminum hydride. So that's all about our reduction reactions. Thank you.